So what does it mean? It means the whole world is led by my soul. Amen. And is it understood? And so no good things should come to you at any point in your life and say, take this and deny Jesus. Do this and deny Jesus. Go here and deny Jesus. Because whatever you offer will be less than the soul. Amen. Once you know this, you go just out and you tell people, I am a child of God. Tell somebody, I am a child of God. Tell somebody, I am born again. Tell somebody, I seek your promise. Let people know who you are, because you are fearfully and wonderfully made. If somebody thinks you are not beautiful, it is his opinion, it is what? Or at least it is what? If he thinks you are not born again, it is what? Opinion. If he thinks you are not rich enough, it is what? His opinion. Depending on who you are being compared with, you can be beautiful, taller, smaller, bigger. No matter, that is just who you are being compared with. It's a matter of comparison. So the first thing is that I wish I knew my worth in Christ. The second thing is that I wish I had mastered the art of setting goals. I wish I had mastered the art of setting goals. I was a very goal-oriented person. My wife will tell you when I met her, we were in the village, and then I told her, we will speak English. And we had to speak English, even though we were in the village. And I told all my friends, we will speak English. By the time I went to secondary school, they were telling me I was the minister's son, because of the way I spoke. And yet my father was teaching in a vertical. I told them I went to cycle. They said, no, I went to much further. Tell people, let people know what you are about. Tell somebody, I want to go to this secondary school. From there, God willing, I want to go to this university. And from there, God willing, I want to do this and also this job. And then, God willing, I want to be married to this type of person. And then, I want to work at this place. You know somebody like that here? Who's always talking about what he wants to do? You know somebody like that? You have to be somebody like that. Let people know what you are about. Let people know what you are about. David said, is there not a cause? I came to deliver light, but is there not a cause? Hallelujah. Now, the third thing, I wish, in fact, the second thing, right of the vision, Luke chapter 40, verse 28, does a man start something and does not count the cost? You must have spiritual goals, you must have social goals, you must have academic goals. The first thing you must master before you turn the church, network. Don't leave here today knowing only we are the Christian members. I said what? Don't leave here today knowing only we are the Christian members. Are you sure there are some of you who don't even know the people you attend, team, class? This is not a good habit. Those of us who are introverts, we are like that. We won't talk to you until you talk to us. And so we are watching what you say. Unless you start a conversation, you will not start. You will not say how, unless you say how. If you are that type of person, you will miss a lot of things in your life. I say you do well. You will miss, because when you are discouraged, your name will never come up. Because nobody will remember you. Oh, that boy, that boy, that boy, that boy, that boy, that boy, that boy. And yet your friend, that boy. And then he said, oh, what about that? Oh, yeah, yes, yes, yes. They won't remember you. And you will be lagging behind your peers. Network. David was a networking guy. In fact, David is the only person I know in this town who had friends in the Philistines. He had friends in the, what do you call it, Moabites. He had friends in the palace. He had friends who were soldiers. That was why, as Saul was chasing him, he never caught him. Because he kept on moving from friend to friend. You go to Gath, you go to Ashkelon, you go to Moab, you go to. He had friends everywhere. To the extent that Jonathan, the one who was the heir apparent, you know who had an heir apparent is. The next was even his friend. Ask the person, who is your friend? And ask the neighbor, who is your friend? Let the person ahead tell me, who is your friend here? Who knows you here? Somebody said, there is no who you know anymore. It is who knows you. Ask who knows you here. When they are calling people to do things, they call you, ask people. You think you are hiding, they don't have you. Therefore, I wish I had mastered the use of my talent. I wish I had mastered the use of my talent. I wasn't particularly athletic, but I could tell stories. I could tell stories. I could gather people around and engage them in talking. But I thought it was just funny. Maybe you have a talent, computer like me. You have a talent, second. And what about you call me? Who should come and sit? No. Who come and sit? No. One people start saying, when they mention something, and people start saying, so do I know. It means that I'm acknowledging the one talent. I said, so I'm acknowledging the one. Once they say, we want someone to pray, and people say, call my friend, call my friend. It means that I'm not one. Then I'm not one. Don't say, I'm not one. No. No. One way, dominate yourself. No. You are killing your talent. I wish I had known my talent. By now, I'll be on very, very few platforms. But I did not know my talent. I thought it was just talking. I wish I had known how to mix my talent with my schooling. I wish I had studied about it. I didn't know. So I did not master it. I did not. People kept on telling me, write a book, write a book. As far as essays, and I kept on telling myself, how can I write a book? Whenever people start acknowledging your talent, work at it. Who are the musicians in this house? Who can play instruments? By hand, who can sing? Hey, I have very shy people here. Who can sing me a good? There are two people I'm singing. You saw what happened to my main artist. She started in the choir. Once I saw her with a mentor, the sister is Chacon, and they were singing. And now you see how she has evolved. Know your talent and all the big names you hear about, the Microsoft people, all of them, they got to know their talent and they started working at it. Now, the real number five. I wish I had mastered the art of selling. I wish I had mastered the art of selling or marketing. I wish I had mastered it. There is one kind of job opportunity that never runs out, and it is marketing. Because as for the programs, they are there, but who will market them? But the programs are there, who will market them? The radio station is there, who will market it? The TV station. So when they tell you, go and sell this thing, don't go, it's not part of my story, they want to sell the house. Or, no. You must learn how to sell, especially how to sell yourself. I say, how to sell what? You must learn to sell yourself. There's a reason our pastors dress the way they dress, because nobody will hear what you are saying unless you look it. Amen. There's a reason. Those in the back, they will question. You see that the West, those in the back, if I'm bringing my money to you and you address them without bringing money. But because you West, I think that you are the rich, so you don't have my money. It is not the right impression, but it's a good impression. Always create the right impression. Carry yourself with an air of confidence. Let people see you and see your face. Amen. Don't be like, you know, that always happens. No. Raise your head up. I see you up. Raise your head up. Raise your head up. Market yourself. Now, the what number are we on? Self-promotion. I talk about self-promotion. We are not on self-promotion. On self-promotion. Everybody who is somebody sells himself. my profile here. They are promoting me. Why do we introduce chairman as apostle professor? We are promoting him. Why do we always want to talk about the school you went? We are promoting you. Because you are people who only listen to someone the thing they can look at. If you are before them, they will listen to you. That should be my teacher. You should know and learn how to tell yourself. Walk straight up. When you are meeting someone, look at his face and greet his family. Greet someone in the family, look at their face.
You should learn how to judge our time. One of the
greatest things in me is that we treat every prior person as a good person and every other person as a bad person. In fact, the Bible will be at the worst, they can be the worst. Learn how to gather around. And how do you do that? You watch how they do it to other people. You watch how they behave when they are angry. You watch how they do when they are happy. And you can decide from that. If you don't learn that, people are abuse you throughout your life. That was number 10. Number 11. You should learn the act of following. You should learn how to submit yourself to mentorship that you are doing here. Learn how to submit yourself to become how to do things properly. That is number 11. Number 12. Learn how to live according to God's purpose. You may live for a long time, but Bible says, I call you to your mother's school. Everyone has been called, even at a young age. So learn how to know what God has called you to do. Once you know that, your life is not much easier because you start bigger and you learn. You see someone saw his purpose when he was just a little child. And because of that, he was one of the great prophets of all. Then we have memorization of scriptures. That was cool. That's special. I wish I remember mastered how to memorize scriptures. I know it's not just to teach us to memorize some scriptures. That's what I'm talking about. I'm talking about scriptures that are important. My God has supplied my government according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Those scriptures, that when you are being tempted, it will come to your head. The Bible says that only God should listen. Memorize scriptures that when the devil brings things into your mind, those scriptures will spring up in defense. Once you learn that, Jesus himself did that in Luke chapter 2, verse 43 to 47. And then the act of following. We go to Galatians chapter 1, verse 15 to 16. And then 14, that's my one. I wish I had learned how to channel my passion into activities. Even though you are sitting here fighting like that, there's a place that if I find you'll be shouting, screaming, maybe it's under a football match. When I think in a football match, you don't get tired. Why? Because you are passionate about it. Maybe if I'm using the place and I'm trying to be shouting, once you come to church, the reason will tell you to shout and do those things. We want you to have passion for this thing because this is more important than anything else in your life, church. We want you to be passionate about church. And once you're passionate, you go to the extra mile, you go to the street, you do things that people do not understand. And that one is the Psalm 9, verse 1. Worship the Lord with all your heart and all your soul with all your mind. Now let's go to the last one because of time. I wish I had mastered how to use gratitude as prayer. Gratitude as prayer. How many people have been telling their parents, oh, daddy, you are the best. Mommy, I love this food. Who would want to do that? Hey, there are a lot of you, your food is small. You should just say, daddy, I've been thanking you for paying my fees and I'm so glad you sent me to that place. And the more you do that, the more you will do more, the more your mom will do more. Let's use gratitude, not only when something has been done, but so that you will get more from where you came from. Learn to use gratitude as a prayer. I pray that these 15 things that you have learned, we will use them. Because once we do, our lives will transform and we champions who are going to be raised to remain in Christ. Amen.